Welcome back, everyone. This is the second video about the analysis of periodic bars. In our previous video, we introduced how we applied what we learned about discrete systems and periodic analysis on the finite element model of a bar. Remember that the finite element is a model of the bar. Actually, we can obtain the equations of motion using any way to get the system upon which we can apply the periodic analysis. However, in my lectures, I will be focusing on the models obtained through finite element modeling. Now, if we use the finite element model of a three-node bar, the three-node bar actually, as its name shows, is a bar element that has three nodes in it. Thus, when we use two elements for the modeling of a cell, we will have 5 degrees of freedom. When we have 5 degrees of freedom of a structure, we are kind of confident to a very good extent that the accuracy of the evaluation of the first two frequencies, at least, is accurate enough. If you are interested in learning more about the finite element analysis and especially that of bars, you can follow the links on the presentation. Also, the code that analyzed the periodic bar using two nodes or three nodes is available on the website. Let's jump into the results right away. As you can see here, it is very clear that we have a similar behavior at low frequencies in the eigenvalues. There is the stop band, but it moved a little bit. Instead of extending from about 6,000 or 7,000 radians per second to 11, it's now extended to just below the 10,000 range. However, when we go further, we can see another stop band appearing here in the range of about 16,000 to 17,000 16,000 to 17,000 radians per second. If we transform this into the coefficient of propagation, you can see here the first stop band is almost in the same place, but a little bit shifted. And another stop band is appearing, followed by a pass band. Since we already know that the higher frequencies will not give us accurate enough results, we will focus only on the lower frequencies. If we now obtain the response of a periodic bar that consisted of 10 cells, we can see again very clearly the drop in the amplitude of the vibration response corresponding to the first stop band. And even you can see here that there is a significant drop corresponding to the second stop band. This will extend for any more bands that we get. Actually, you can use more than two-node elements to present each element here. More than three-node element, or even use more than one element per bar to increase the number of degrees of freedom. However, the first stop band will not change much. All the changes will appear in the other stop bands. These results, as I said before, were verified by experiments performed by Professor Saeed Al-Asiri of King Abdulaziz University in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Here I'm showing a part of his profile page on ResearchGate. You can access this page using the link here. Also, you can find a lot of other research that he has published on that page. So much of it is concerned with the use of periodic bars. So, for now, what we did is introduced the effect of periodicity on periodic bars. In the following lecture, we will start talking about periodic beams. But now we are starting to talk about realistic structures. as I mentioned, Dr. Said Lasiri, he has already applied this to applied the stop bands of periodic bars to realistic structures, and you can see his publications about that. Experiments verified the accuracy of the model. In the following lectures, we will start talking about beams. Also, personally, I have used or performed experiments on periodic beams and a variety of numerical problems were also handled using periodic beams. All this have shown how periodic analysis can really predict the performance of periodic structures. Also, there are another family of periodic plates that we will mention later. Nevertheless, we can now really use these things through analysis. Another problem that I will introduce later is the periodic design. What if I want to design a structure for a certain stop band? That's not so difficult for bars. It was a big problem, at least for me, when handling beams, until Dr. Peter Bishai have published recently a paper on the design of periodic beams that I will also be introducing later. I hope that you will play around with the code available on the website, that you will read further in this topic. It is a very interesting topic. A lot of applications can come out of it, in real life applications. There are, of course, some limitations to what we can do with periodic beams or periodic structures generally, especially damping low frequencies, which is a very big challenge. I personally love this issue. I've been in love with it for the past 18 years since I started working with periodic structures. But I hope that you find it interesting and that it turns out to be useful to you. Hope to see you in future lectures about periodic structures on the Academy of Knowledge. Thank you very much.